despite having done the advanced degree work in psychology, one of my advanced degrees, I know quite a bit about the subject, both academically and as a practitioner. Yes, the vast, vast majority of so-called psychologists, quacks, and witch doctors really would disagree with what I'm about to say. But Adler and Viktor Frankl, the two quasi-Einstein caliber psychologists we've had, would agree. If there were one test for clinical health, that is, life in the individual, it would be to test for the shield the innocent victim reflex. And I'm trying to think who I know that has that reflex. My dad did. Diane Wilson does. Maybe 10 to 20,000 of, was it 60 million Germans did during World War II, the non-Jewish rescuers and shielders of Jews during the Holocaust. Eleanor Roosevelt did. Jesus did, of all people. Gandhi, King. Kafar Khan, Frontier Gandhi, did. Within our personal lives, we do, some of us. But really not anymore. I was thinking of some people I know well who, in the most obvious situations, yes, but as their children's and grandchildren's future is being irrevocably and unimaginably turned into a irredeemable hell, physical hell on earth. No, there's no shield the innocent victim reflex. Let's go have dinner. Let's go to work. Let's turn on the TV. Let's watch a movie. Let's go to a 2-hour demonstration. This is so Kafka-esque, but I can't say I'm surprised. But there are no signs of life. There's no shield the innocent victim reflex. Look in the mirror.